अब मैं रामकृष्ण मिशन तथा रामकृष्ण मठखार मुंबई के प्रमुख अध्यक्ष, वेदांत सार सरल भाषा में साधारण व्यक्तियों तक पहुंचाने वाले नित्य नूतन योजनाओं से साधकगण में मठ के प्रति लगाव और सेवा का चाव बढ़ाने वाले श्रद्धेय स्वामी सर्वलोकानंद जी महाराज से विनती करती हूं कि वे इस शुभ अवसर पर सबका स्वागत करें। स्वामी सर्वलोकानंद महाराज जी।
नमस्त्री जतिराजाय विवेकानंद सूरये सच्चित् सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिने। ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ 120th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ हिस्टोरिक वॉयज ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद from Mumbai port to America to attend the Parliament of Religions at Chicago. All of you know, I heartily welcome Sri Pranab Mukherjee, the Honorable President of India, the Governor, Sri K. Sankarananji, then Swami Suviranandha, Assistant Secretary, Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission, Belur Math, Sri L. K. Advaniji, ex-Deputy Prime Minister and Senior Member of Parliament, then Sri Suresh Sethi, Minister of State of Maharashtra, then Sri Sunil Prabhu, the Mayor of Mumbai, then our what is called Dr. Manohar Joshi, ex-Chief Minister of Maharashtra, and Sri Sudhilda Kulkarni, Chairman Observer Research Foundation. All of you know that Swami Vivekananda visited great city of Mumbai thrice, but his second visit to Mumbai is very important and historic because he sailed for America from Mumbai port on 31st May 1893. Dear friends, Swami Vivekananda, when he was traveling length and breadth of India to know India, first time he came to know about the Parliament Religions to be held in Chicago, in Kathiawar, in Gujarat, Saurashtra. The Maharaja of Mysore and Raja of Ramnath had requested Swami Vivekananda to represent Hinduism in the Parliament of Religions. But Swamiji refused their request because Swamiji was in dilemma whether to go to America or not, because he was not invited the speaker by the Committee of the Parliament of Religions at Chicago. Swamiji had one day vision that his Guru Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was walking on the water of the ocean and beckoning him to follow him. At the same time, Swamiji heard the voice, "Go to America." Not only that, Swamiji got blessings and permission from Sri Sarada Devi, the spiritual consort of Sri Ramakrishna, to go to America. Further, she said that this Parliament of Religions is meant for you only. After that, after reaching America, Swami Vivekananda had to pass through a lot of difficulties, hurdles, obstacles, and struggle, and finally he appeared in the Parliament of Religions at Chicago. After his first speech in the opening session of the Parliament, Swami Vivekananda overnight became the hero and the great spiritual teacher of the world. He preached the universal brotherhood, the tolerance, the acceptance, the peace and harmony through the Sanatana Dharma, that is eternal religion of India. He emphasized the synthesis or one kind of blending of the spirituality of the East and the science and technology of the West for the material and spiritual development, material and spiritual development of the world. Dear friends, Swami Vivekananda not only discovered the soul of India, but Swami Vivekananda also discovered the soul of America. There is no doubt about it. Dear friends, now time is short, so Swamiji gave us what is called the gift unopened. We have not opened the gift due to our ignorance, because Swamiji has given very valuable gift, his life-giving and strengthening message. In the present scenario, it is very high time that we should read Swamiji, know Swamiji, spread Swamiji for individual benefit and also the benefit of the society and nay, the benefit of the whole world. Once again, I would like to welcome all of you, including the dignitaries present on the dais, an audience in this beautiful auditorium of the Mumbai University. Namaskar, Dhanyavad.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll now invite Swami Shubhirananda Maharaji, Assistant Secretary, Ramakrishna Mission and the Ramakrishna Math from Belur Math, to say a few words to this distinguished audience. Swami Shubhirananda Maharaji.
Namasri Yatirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Sachit Sukha Sarupayo Swamine Tapoharine. Very, very respected Rashtrapati ji, His Excellency Sri Shankar Narayanan ji, the Governor of Maharashtra, very respected Sri L.K. Advani ji, former Deputy Prime Minister of India, Swami Sarvalokananda ji, the head of our center at Mumbai, Sri Manohar Joshi ji, ex-Chief Minister of Maharashtra and former Speaker of the Lok Sabha, Sri Suresh Sethi ji, Honorable Minister, Government of Maharashtra for Health and Family Welfare, etc., Mayor of the Municipal Corporation of Mumbai, Sri Sunil Prabhu ji, Sri Sudhindra Kulkarni ji, and other dignitaries present on the dais on this august occasion, my monastic brothers present here, and the August gathering. In the late 19th century, America was a grand witness to three great revolutions. The first was a struggle for independence as a new nation from the tyranny of unheeding power. The second was a civil war which amplified in principle the rights of all citizens, and the third was an industrial revolution which opened up world markets but didn't bring about corresponding advances in the consciousness of man. Just at the time in India, a new Christ was born. A silent revolution took place. An unknown mendicant was christened to Swami Vivekananda, who was destined to shake the world stage, move America to its very foundations, to shift America to a new culture. And the ethos of fraternity, respect for pluralistic principle, and cooperation and love. Swami Vivekananda roused the consciousness of a sleeping giant, weary of wealth and power and its attendant moral decay. He ushered in a new revolution, a revolution of the spirit in the evolution of mankind. 120 years ago, it is on this day, the 31st of May, that the soul of Swami Vividishananda left our Narenbhai and a new soul entered into him, known as Swami Vivekananda. This was an advent on the American scene of a voice from the East which sowed the seeds of regeneration of a great people called Americans. His Excellency Sri Ajit Singhji, the Sion of Khetri and the first disciple of Swamiji, proposed this historic name for the Swamiji. Quote, "Swamiji, from today, let the world know you as Swami Vivekananda," said he, unquote. A mendicant became a prophet, as he himself wrote from America to India. Quote, "By combining some of the active and heroic elements of the West with the calm virtues of the Hindus, there will come a type of man far superior to any that have ever been in the world," unquote. It is of this messenger we speak today here, hoping that our countrymen will find that time, that find that the time has come to open the great gift that he gave us. The author of the gift unopened, Mr. Eleanor Sterk, Swami Sarvalokananda ji has already mentioned about this book. He writes in his famous book, The Gift Unopened, I quote, "If Columbus discovered the soil of America, Vivekananda discovered the soul of America," unquote. The question is, didn't Swamiji rediscover the soul of India? I'm absolutely sure all of you live with me when I say yes, an emphatic yes. What we say is, Vivekananda didn't discover the soul of America alone. Vivekananda discovered the soul of the entire world, the mankind. It is too much to expect another Vivekananda so soon. But we can always follow and draw inspiration from his legacy he left behind him. Before I wrap up, may I quote from a motion which was passed unanimously in the British Parliament on January 28, 2013. I quote, that this house, on the 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, recognizes the valuable contribution made by him to interfaith dialogue at international level, encouraging and promoting harmony
and understanding between religions through his renowned lectures and presentations between religions. At the first World Parliament of Religions in Chicago in 1893, followed by his lecture tours in the US, England, and mainland Europe, notes that this rectified and improved the understanding of the Hindu faith outside India and dwelt upon the universal goodness found within all religions. Further notes that he inspired thousands to selflessly serve the distressed and those in need and promoted an egalitarian society free from all kinds of discrimination and welcomes the celebrations of his 150th birth anniversary in the UK and throughout the world, unquote. On this occasion, may I request our illustrious leaders of national stature present here today to explore the possibility of adopting such a motion in both the houses of the Parliament of the Indian Republic. We are already one step behind the British Parliament in this regard, but as they say, it's better late than never. In fine, as a humble soldier of the spiritual militia founded by our leader Swami Vivekananda, let us pray at his holy lotus feet. Sarve sukhina bhavantu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukham apnuvat. Let all be happy, let all be free from ailments, let all be blessed with the vision of truth, beauty and goodness, let misery touch none. Thank you so very much. Thank you.
I now call upon a political leader who considers himself to be a teacher first, Dr. Manohar Joshi, former Chief Minister of Maharashtra, ex-Speaker of the Lok Sabha, and a committed educationist who has done a lot to provide job-oriented training at several centers to semi-skilled youth. Devi aur Sajjano, swagat kijiye Dr. Manohar Joshi ji ka.
Sri Pranab Mukherjee, the President of India, Sri Shankar Narayanan, Governor of Maharashtra, Sri Lal Krishna Advani ji, Mr. Shetty, the Honorable Minister of Maharashtra, the Mayor of Mumbai, Sri Prabhu, distinguished saints and dear friends. I must first thank sincerely Sri Pranab Mukherjee ji for attending this important function being held in Mumbai. I welcome him and also, I consider it my good fortune to participate in this function to commemorate the 120th year of Swami Vivekananda's voyage from Mumbai to Chicago in 1893. I believe in repeating that Mumbai is taking the lead in paying tribute to great patriot saint since the historic voyage began here. There are many facets to Swami Vivekananda's life and personally, but I will narrate only two little known incidents from his life that relate to Maharashtra. आपल्या सर्वांचं मनापासून स्वागत करताना मला अतिशय आनंद होत आहे. मी मनापासून आपल्या सर्वांचं स्वागत करतो आणि स्वामी विवेकानंदांबद्दल चार शब्द बोलताना जो आनंद आपल्या सर्वांच्या मनात आहे तोच माझ्याही मनात आहे हे नम्रपणाने आपल्याला सांगतो. इन 1892 बिफोर द फेमस पार्लमेंट वर्ड्स रिव्हिजन्स हेल्ड इन शिकागो वेन लोकमान्य बाळ गंगाधर टिळक द ग्रेट पेट्रियट स्कॉलर अँड सम ऑफ द सॉइल वॉज ट्रॅव्हलिंग फ्रॉम मुंबई टू पुणे ही सॉ ए संन्यासी enter the same coach as him. He was introduced to the sannyasi who then came to the residence of Tilak's house in Pune for 10 days. It was in 1897 when Swami Vivekananda returned to India after the grand success at the Parliament of World's Religions that Tilak identified him as the nameless Swami who had resided at Hirdre's house when Tilak visited the Belur Math of the Ramakrishna Mission. Swami Vivekananda received him very cordially. In the course of the conversation, Swamiji remarked somewhat in a lighter vein that Tilak should take up his work in Bengal while he would go to and continue the latter's work in Maharashtra. One does not carry the same influence in his own province as in distant one. Now, I shall come to Swami Vivekananda's inspiring song and thoughts on Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. After the great Maratha warrior, he sang, "As the forest fire is to the forest trees, a leopard to the deer herds, and lion to the stately elephants, as the sun is to darkness of the night, as Krishna was to Kamsa, so was the Shivaji a lion towards the hordes of foreigners." Describing Shivaji as the greatest king that India has produced in the last 300 years and as the real son of India, Swamiji decried the fact that the history of India written by foreigners alone was taught to children. Friends, this brings me finally the topic close to my heart. Swami Vivekananda's thought on a man making education. Here I would like to quote Swamiji. He said, "We want that education, very important matter, and that too particularly coming hundreds of years back." He said, "We want that education by which character is formed, strength of mind is created, the intellect is expanded, and by which one can stand on one's own feet, particularly in the University of Mumbai's hall, particularly in the presence of a vice chancellor. This is very important. The expectation of Mr. Swami Vivekananda." To quote Swamiji again, he was very critical of getting by heart the thoughts of others, as in foreign language, stuffing your brain with them and taking some university degrees. For him, the education that does not help the common mass of people to equip themselves for life's struggles, which does not bring out strength of character, a spirit of philanthropy, and a courage of lion, was not worth the name. Strongly advocated, Vivekananda ji said, "Technical education and all eggs which may develop industries so that man, instead of seeking the service, may earn enough to provide for themselves and save something against a rainy day. The importance of technical education was understood by Swami Vivekananda during his times also. As I conclude my speech, I cannot help but express my sadness at the fact that the state government has done a great injustice to the people of Maharashtra by not giving the importance to the 158th birth anniversary celebration of an extraordinary Indian. To bind not only idea, but the whole universe in a harmonious symphony of love, service and renunciation. I hope that the government of Maharashtra, particularly their representative Mr. Shetty and the others present here, will make the amendments to this function. My thanks to everybody. Dhanyavad. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra, Jai Vande Mataram. Namaskar.